Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming along to today's very interesting, very important press conference. My name is David McNeil. I'm your moderator today. As everybody in the room will no doubt know, the former boxer Iwao Hakamada-san was released from prison late last month. He had served 48 years in prison for a crime it looks like he did not commit. For most of that period, he was waiting to be hung, and for a great deal of that period, he was in solitary confinement, which is the way that death row prisoners in Japan are treated. The release of Hakamada-san triggers many important questions about the death penalty in Japan. You may know, for example, that the Shizuoka prosecutors have decided to appeal his case, apparently immune to some of the humanitarian issues in his incarceration, the fact that he's 78 years of age and in bad health. It also raises issues about the secrecy of the death penalty in Japan. You may know that 130 other people are on death row in Japan, which is a record number, record post-war number. Some of them are very old. The oldest, Okunishi Masaru, is 88, in bad health. There have been cases of people being wheeled to the gallows in wheelchairs. This system has been widely criticized by Amnesty International and other groups. Here to talk about this release and implications of this case, we have, first of all, Hakamada-san's tireless sister, Hideko Hakamada. She has been campaigning for her brother's release for decades, basically since he was incarcerated. A remarkable person who, as you can see, is genki, still very genki, past her 80s. Second person we have to talk is Nishijima Katsuhiko. He is the lead lawyer in this case. And the third person is Hideki Wakabayashi. He is the executive director of Amnesty International Japan, which has taken a long-standing interest in this case, both in Japan and worldwide. We'll ask, first of all, Wakabayashi-san to introduce the case to us very briefly. We will then hear from Hakamada-san, who will explain both her brother's condition since he's been released and her tireless fight to have him freed. And then we will hear from Nishijima-san, the lawyer, about the case itself. Can I ask you, please, if you haven't already, to make sure your phone is switched off and to give them your best attention. We only have an hour today. We're going to try and keep very strongly to 30 minutes for a presentation and then 30 minutes for questions and answers. So please give them your best attention.
Thank you very much for your kind introduction. I will be speaking English briefly, try to save time. On behalf of National Hakamada Support Committee, which consists of 8 groups, and some of the leaders are sitting over there. And I would like to begin my briefing by saying that we need your help. We need your help to disseminate this information to the world, because Mr. Hakamada has been detained for 48 years without having a fair trial, being forced to confession, and tortures, and at Daiyo Kangoku from the morning to night. And he doesn't have any access to the public, and so many 20 days of interrogation from morning and night. So there's many problems, wrongdoings of Japanese criminal system that you might be interested in. So, and also the local court clearly indicate that there's high possibility that some evidence, including a set of clothes, 5 clothes, have been fabricated. So, but unfortunately, the prosecutors appealed on the 31st of March. And I think time is running out for Hakamada-san, for 78 years old. And this decision by Japanese prosecutors only add another psychological tortures. I think prosecutors should withdraw this appeal as soon as possible. Amnesty International has been working on this case since 2008. And as an individual at risk, we have receiving so many signatures, letters from all over the world. I think world is watching. again, you have a very, very important role to bring justice to Japan. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hakamada-san, onegaishimasu. Our translator today, by the way, is Murayama-san.
Hakamada de gozaimasu.
Thank you very much. My name is Hakamada.
まあ、私の手元に帰ってまいりました。まだ岩尾は自由になったという認識は少しはあるんですけど、ちょっと行動がおかしい行動を取ります。だんだんに良くなっていくと思いますが、拘禁症が一番激しいのかなと私は感じております。昨日面会行きましたけど、やっぱり変なことをいたします。これも気長に見守っていきたいと思っております。皆様に応援していただき本当に感謝しております。ありがとうございました。
So, thank you very much for attending this press conference. I would like to report to you that my brother Hakamada Iwao has been released, and his recognition, cognition is well, and he is recovering very gradually. And there are some cases of some disabilities in his behavior, but however, sometimes he does some strange behavior. But I believe in him that he will be recovering very soon. But I think that the greatest point that he is suffering from is a side effect of incarceration. And as yesterday I went to see him, he did something a little strange. But I would like to take a long standpoint so that he will be recovering fully. And may I take this opportunity to thank you for all of your support.
Thank you. Nishijima-sensei? Okay, desu ka? Hai.
Bengudan-chou no Nishijima desu. Hakamada-jiken no ikisatsu toka, jiken no nakami sono mono nitsuite wa jikan ga arimasen node shouryaku shitai to omoimasu.
So I am the chief attorney for Hakamada, and I would like to refrain from speaking in detail about the background or the contents of actually what happened during the trial.
Shizuoka Chisai ga saishin kaishi kettei o shita sono iigi, sono kettei o dou watashi tachi wa uketometara ii no ka ni shibotte o hanashi o shitai to omoimasu.
I would like to focus on the point that the Shizuoka District Court has decided to do a retrial.
日本の再審制度は再審請求という段階とそれを受けた再審公判という2つの手続きに分かれています。
So in Japan, the court procedure is divided into two aspects. One is a retrial application, and secondly is retrial court proceedings.
再審開始決定が確定して初めて裁判のやり直し、つまり再審公判に移行しますので、まだまだ時間がかかりそうです。
So after the retrial has been decided, it will take some time for the actual court proceedings to be conducted.
不幸なことに日本の法律では検察官に上訴、不服申し立ての権限を認めておりますので、そのことも相まって裁判が長引くを、危惧されます。
So unfortunately in Japan, we are able to express an appeal for dissatisfaction toward the prosecutors. And so therefore, there is a concern that this trial, this case may be elongated.
2番目の特徴は、有罪の確定判決を、つまり有罪を言い渡した裁判所と同じ裁判所に再審の申し立てをするという手続きになっていることが一つの障害になっています。
Also, another impediment is that we need to take procedures for retrial to the court that actually sentenced him to the actual judgment, which was the death penalty.
そして、新規、新しい、明白な、つまり無罪となることが明白な新証拠を提出しなさいというふうに要求されています。
And we have been asked by the court to submit new evidence that it would clearly state that he is innocent.
この制約は白鳥決定という最高裁の決定によっていくらかハードルが下げられましたけれども、なかなか高い壁です。
Although, due to the Shiratori case, decision, judgment, this, the hurdle of having to prove that it, a person is innocent, a case is innocent, is, has been lowered. However, it still is a, there is a difficulty.
そして4番目の特徴として、弁護側は証拠開示の請求権がない。つまり検察官が手元に隠している証拠を見る権利がないということです。
Also, the fourth point is that the, the defending counsel is not able to, have the evidence being disclosed from the prosecutors. And so therefore, it is, not possible for us to be in touch with the evidence that is being maintained by the prosecutors.
静岡地裁の開始決定はこれらの困難を乗り越えて決定にこぎつけてくれたということになります。
So the judgment made by the, Shizuoka court, the district court, has been realized through the difficulties that we had to surmount in terms of these four points that we had to, overcome.
開始決定の中心は DNA 鑑定によって袴田さんの DNA が5点の衣類から検出できなかったということが大きなポイントになっています。
So final decision was made that, out of the five outfits that was found, in the actual place that the location that the crime was committed, the DNA did not, fit, did not testify that Hakamoto-san was the actual criminal.
しかしそれにとどまらず、弁護側で味噌漬けにされた着衣と同じ条件を設定して、味噌漬けの実験をしたその結果が高く評価されています。
However, on the other hand, the defense counsel has been, has tried a experiment of trying to test the, clothes, the outfits that has been soaked in miso paste.
そしてこれらの新証拠を支えるものとして検察官がしぶしぶ裁判所の勧告に従ってこれまで隠し続けてきた証拠を開示したその成果が生かされております。
So with the new evidence that was, submitted, we were able to have the prosecutors disclose the evidence that was on their side and this brought about the result that we were able to attain.
開始決定の第二の特徴は証拠の評価が非常に常識的な判断だということです。
So another point regarding, the start of the retrial is, that,
証拠の見方。
The evaluation of the, evidence was high.
このことは特に着衣の色について判断している部分が特徴的です。
So the characteristic of this point is that, there has been a, decision made in regard to the color of the outfits.
誰が見ても色は同じに見えると、これは重要な事実だということを指摘しています。
So regardless of who sees the outfit, the colors are the same. And so this is a very important evidence.
つまり事件から1年後に裁判の途中で発見された衣類が本当に1年間使っていたのか、それとも発見直前にタンクに入れられたのか、これは色を見ればわかるではないかということを言ってるわけです。
So as for, what was found a year, about a year or some later, the outfits that were discovered, we can see whether that was actually, that testifies whether he was, he, is innocent or not, by considering the fact that it might be that the outfits were placed in the tank. And so the colors can testify to this point.
そしてこの決定の特徴はそういった不自然な証拠がたくさん現れている。これはなぜだろうかということで判断を進めて、これは捏造としか考えられないと というふうに、言い切っております。
So therefore there was unnatural evidences that were brought forward and therefore led to the fact that、the judgment was not correct、that is the death penalty was not correct and it also led to the fact thatthe evidence and the position of the prosecutors was only a fabrication.
しかもそれができるのは捜査機関を置いて他にはないと思われるというところまで断言しております。
So also it has been proven that this can only be judged by the investigating squad.
そしてその目は、つまり監察官は5点の衣類にとどまらず他の証拠についてもそのような観点から厳密に検討する必要があるというふうに言って全ての証拠について検討を加えているわけです。
So from the、perspective of looking at points for example the five outfits and other、aspects as well、it has been、judged that it, we need to look at this case from multifoldaspects.
被告人は嘘つきだとか権力は悪いことはしないというそういうドグマにとらわれないで常識的な証拠評価をしたところにこの決定の有力な意味があると思います。
So disregarding、the fact that、regarding the fact that、the、Takamada was to be considered a liarOr that、the evidence that was、found was not actually something that would testify to his、sentence, and、this being limited to the dogma that this evidence was these evidences were unnatural, then、we feel that、the、normal evidence、which is not natural.Normal evidence should be looked at in this case has become an important factor in determining、the current condition.
そして3つ目の特徴は画期的な死刑囚の釈放を命じたことであります。
And the third point is the epochal fact that the Takamado who has been sentenced to death penalty has been released from prison.
これまで第一段階の再審請求審で釈放されることはありませんでした。
In the first stage of the retrial appeal, it was not possible.
第二段階の再審公判で無罪判決が出てから釈放を命ずるというのがこれまでの例でした。
So in previous cases, when at the second stage of court proceedings, the release of a person of an individual was only possible after innocence was proven.
この重大な決断を裁判所が下した理由は何だろうかということを紹介したいと思います。
So, I would like to touch upon the fact that the fact why the court had made this very important decision.
決定は次のように言っております。警察が人権を顧みることなく袴田を犯人として厳しく追及した。
So the decision of the court was based on theFirst point, which was that、the prosecutors had infringed upon human rights and had tortured、Hakamada for his confession.
無実の個人を45年以上にわたって拘束し続けたことは刑事司法の理念からは到底耐え難い。
And it, he、also the court ruled that、it is just unwithstandable thatan innocent person has been incarcerated for a period of more than 40 years.
拘置をこれ以上継続することは耐え難いほど正義に反する。
So to have him remain in prison is、just unwithstandable in terms of justice.
私はこれらの表現の中にこれまでの先輩裁判官が犯してきた誤りを正し、司法に正義を取り戻すという強い決意が込められていると思います。
So I believe that these reasonings of the court explains to us that the court had reflected on the mistakes that was committed by the senior judges in the past, and they are taking a stance of trying to have justice being proven.
この決定に対して検察官が即時抗告をしましたけれども、我々は全く不当な抗告だと思っております。
Although the prosecutors have made an immediate appeal regarding this judgment, this decision, we believe that this is a unjust appeal.
弁護団は総力を挙げてこれに徹底的に叩いていきたいと思います。
So the defense counsel would like to thoroughly fight against the prosecutors.
世論の強力な支援をお願いする次第です。
And I wish to express my deepest wish that the public will support us.
最後に一つだけ。
And finally, a final point.
この決定をどういうふうに生かしていくかということですけれども、現在法制審議会に刑事法特別部会というところで、司法制度の改革が議論されておりますけれども、この袴田の決定を絶対に無視してはいけないと思います。
So, this is regarding how we are going to utilize the decision that was made by the court. There is different committees within the legal structure of our nation, and there is a special committee to reform the legal structure of our country of Japan. And so therefore, I believe that we should utilize this in order to reform the current state, and would like to express my deepest determination to do this.
例えば全面的証拠開示、あるいは取り調べの全プロセスの可視化、そして弁護人の立ち会い、その、拷問取り調べの根源になっている代用監獄の廃止などです。
Also, I would like the examples of this would be to disclose all evidences, also to have all interrogations of the prosecutors being visible, made visible, and access to the interrogations of the criminal, and also regarding 最後は何としたの？
代用監獄。
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 System of incarceration.
Pardon? Reason of retention cell. Okay. 代用監獄。Okay.
そして2番目に私たちが追及しなきゃいけないのは、冤罪原因を究明する第三者機関を早急に立ち上げることだと思います。
And the third point I would like to stress that there is a need for a third party, a third organization to look after the cases where criminals are accused for a false accusation.
本来は警察、検察、そして裁判所も自ら検証すべきでありますけれども、もしそれらが行われないというなら、この第三者機関の設置は必須のものだと思います。
So police, prosecutors, and people who verify are involved in a court case. But if, for example, when this is not sufficient, I believe that there is a need for establishing a third organization or institution.
その場合、司法、裁判所が聖域になってはいけないと思います。
So the court should not become a sacred place.
最後に死刑廃止を正面から議論する時期に来ていると思います。
And the final point is that we need to stress the point that capital punishment should be done away with.
ありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
Thank you to our three speakers for keeping so strictly to the time. We'll take questions from the working press first, and then we'll open it up to the rest of the audience. Can I remind you, when you come to the microphone, can you state your name, the name of your organization, and who you would like to address the question to? I see PO's hand first, so we'll have a question from him.
Peter Milia from SkyTG24. First of all, I know that in Italy we usually hug people. I cannot hug you, Mr. Hagamata-san, but on behalf of the community of Sant'Egidio, where you participated in many symposium at the Italian Bunka Kaikan, let me really virtually hug you for this achievement. I have one question for Wakabayashi-san and for the lawyer. Wakabayashi-san, I understand, I may not be exact in figures, but I understand there are 120, David?
130.
Under 30 people still in the death row in Japan. As Amnesty International, do you have any research, any figure of how many of these cases could be at least doubtful? Okay. And there's a question for the lawyer is a question that maybe is very important for us all here, because we heard that in the last months and years something have changed at parliament level, legislative level, but would you kindly tell us exactly what are the rights of a hikokunin, I don't know in English.
Defendants.
Defendant at the very first stage. Okay, you are detained in the police in the Daiyo Kangoku, and can you stay silent, or can you do you have the right or not to legal assistance during the very first summoning, or not? Thank you.
Hi, 私は24フィルとおっしゃいましたでしょうかから来ましたものですけれども、まず最初に袴田さんのお姉様をこの場で、今はこの場所にいますので、ちょっと抱擁したりすることはできないんですけれども、抱擁したい思いでいっぱいです。で、私どものイタリアのコミュニティセンターの方にいらっしゃっていただいて、会議にご出席いただいたことも深く感謝をしたいと思います。私の方からは2つ質問がありますけど、まず若林さんに質問をさせていただきたいと思います。今現在死刑を勧告されているのが180人以上いらっしゃるということなんですけど、130人以上いらっしゃるということなんですけれども、アムネスティ・インターナショナルでは、これに対してですね、実際に疑わしいこの死刑ではないという意味でのその疑わしい事例というのは事件というのはどのくらいあると思われますでしょうか。で、2つ目は弁護士の方にお願いしたいんですけれども、これは先月でしょうか、それとも1年前だと思うんですけども、議会の方であったかな動きがあったかと思うんですけれども、これは被告の権利についてお話しご質問させていただきたいと思います。第一段階において、まあ、警察の方から、まあ、代理勧告などもありますけれども、まあ、この、有罪と認められた場合にですね、被告の権利というものはどういったものがありますでしょうか。その黙認する、静かにそれを受け止める、あるいはこの第一ファーストステージ第一段階において法的なアシスタンスを得ることはできるのでしょうか。
じゃあ日本語でしょうか。アムネスティの若林です。最初のご質問に答えたいと思います。死刑確定数今131ですかね。そのちょっと今私も正確につかんでないんですが、まあ、残念ながらアムネスティとしては、まあ、どれぐらい何人の方が冤罪の可能性があるっていう数字はつかんでおりません。運動的には袴田さんと奥西さんのケースが非常にその疑いがあるということでこれまで取り組んできました。ただご案内のとおり、これまでのさまざまなその死刑確定囚以外のですね、冤罪の事件を考えればその可能性も非常に高いですし、1980年代に4人が再審無罪になった以降はそういう方が出てない、まあ、いずれにしましても取り返しのつかないというこの死刑判決についてはやはりもちろんアムネスティとしてはまあ、死刑制度そのものがもちろん反対ですし、まあ、最近ではその誰が処刑されるかというルールも曖昧ですので、最近ではもう確定してから1年数ヶ月で処刑された人もいれば、まあ、奥西さんあるいは袴田さんのように相当期間長い人がやっぱり拘束され続けているという状況であります。だ残念ながらその一件については把握はまだできておりません。
So, as for, I would like to speak in Japanese, there are about 131 cases of people who are sentenced to a death penalty in Japan. And unfortunately, Amnesty International has not been able to grasp the actual number of cases where they are wrongly sentenced. But we have been focusing on Hakamoto-san and Okuni-san cases where we believe that they should be considered as innocent. And however, we do believe that there are other cases where they have been sentenced to capital punishment. But in 1904, there was a retrial, and four cases were proven as innocent. But ever since that, there has not been cases where such cases ever since that time. Anyways, Amnesty International is in the stance, maintains the stance of being opposing capital punishment. And also there's an issue of the rule for capital punishment, the actual execution of the death row. There are cases where it takes about a year or so, or there are cases where immediately done. In the case of Okunishi and Hakamata, they have been incarcerated for a long period of time until the actual death row was to be executed or not.
Can I just clarify something here? There has been no retrial in a capital murder case since 1904?
There are, but released, actually being judged as innocent, 1980s. The four cases, 1980s.
1980s.
Since then, we didn't have any.
Not 1904, I think.
No, 1980s.
1980s, okay.
1980年代.
Correction is 1980s, not 1904.
非常に大きな質問を受けましたので、的確に答えられるかどうか分かりませんけれども、最新の第一段階には最近は徐々に、もし刑務所や拘置所にその人が拘禁されている場合には、立ち会いなしに面会ができるというような法的な援助といいましょうか、がスタートといいましょうか、そういう判例の取り扱いで、いくらか弁護人の弁護活動が自由になりました。しかし、国選弁護制度はありませんし、再審法という手続きが非常に曖昧というか、確固とした手続き保障がないものですから、この袴田の決定を契機にですね、再審手続きを抜本的に改めろということも一つの課題になるだろうと思います。それから第2段階は、
So the first stage regarding this is a very very big question, a very vast question that you asked me to answer. In the first stage of the retrial, there has been an improvement in the prison where we are able to meet the person in incarceration without any person overlooking the actual interview. And therefore, it has facilitated the defendant's activities in that sense. And another point is that in the case of retrial, there is a big issue. This is a very big issue that the procedural guarantee of retrial is something that we need to consider or we need to put forth as an issue. And also about the second stage.
第二段階の再審公判というのは、再審のやりな、あの、裁判のやり直しですので、通常の裁判と同じ手続きになります。
About the retrial of the court proceedings, this is the second stage. It means a redoing of the retrial.
I'm sorry, David, but I don't think the lawyer answered exactly the question, which I think is very important. At this very first stage, I'm not talking about when the prosecution has started. So, excuse me, Mike, Daiokangoku no.
逮捕される後、
黙秘はできますか、弁護団のできますか、そういう質問です。
はい、ま、通常と同じにもちろん黙秘権もあるし面会もできるし弁護士がアドバイスをすることもできます。しかしそれ以上に代用監獄は24時間捜査官の手に握られているわけですから、僕らが面会するのはせいぜい30分か数十分ですので、
1日30分。
そうです。
So yes, yes, silence is permitted. And as for the, in terms of Daiyo Kankoku, there is some person who is overlooking during the meeting of the person who is accused of the crime. And we are only given about 30 minutes as a lawyer to meet with the person accused.
It's also true, is it not, that the prosecution can infer something from your silence? That you, if you stay silent, the prosecution can infer your guilt. Is that not correct? Murayama-san, could you translate that?
この黙認、黙秘をすると、これは検察官が自分の無罪を主張しているということを意味することにもなるのではないでしょうか。
黙秘権は憲法で保障されていますけれども、それを事実上黙秘させないようなテクニックを用いて彼を攻め立てるわけです。
Yes, although silence is given as a right to, by law, they are coerced to say something.
I saw this lady here. Yeah.
So good morning, everyone. And I am a member of the Amnesty International Italian section, who is, I'm a student here, but of course I've taken the chance to be here also this morning. I'm very happy. The whole Italian section is, of course, greeting Mrs. Accamada and expressing our support. I have to say that it's especially the Naples group who is warmly supporting all this. The Italian section has worked very much also on this case since quite long. I can remember that in international festival, the movie festival of Rome in 2010, the movie of Banmei Takahashi Box was actually promoted, and we had also a speech with the death penalty coordinator about Accamada's case. Yes, I'm going to the end. If you don't mind, I would like to finish speaking. Especially if you finish speaking, I would finish. Thank you. And recently, it has to do with abolition, which is always a point. It's not really easy to promote in a country where it looks that more than 80% of people are in support. It looks like at Italia Bunka Kaikan, such as Pio D'Emilia has pointed, we
do need a question because there is only a limited amount of time.
Yes, so, clarify yeah. that this is not exactly the amount. Recently, here the European ambassador said when death penalty was abolished in European countries, there was not so much popular or impact on public opinion. So does it really in Japan here would depend on what we have longly stated as being the response of public opinion in Japan? Or, you know, is there any other chance for go through with
so
this?
So your question is, does the abolition of the death penalty depend on... I'm just clarifying. Does the abolition of the death penalty depend on public opinion? That's what you're saying, because public opinion supported the death penalty in Europe, but it was still abolished.
No, in Japan.
Right, in
I'm
Japan.
I'm not going to repeat, because I was interrupted, so I think I was not able to point out exactly what I wanted to
say. 質問を短くしますと、今、司会者の方がおっしゃったようにですね、ヨーロッパでは、死刑というのが廃止されたわけなんですけども、日本の場合も、やはり世論としてその死刑を支持する形でいるのかどうかということかと思います。
So just to, as background, we should say that public opinion in Japan is very high for the death penalty. Government surveys usually find 80 to 90 or even higher percent in support of the death penalty.
ちょっとバックグラウンドを説明しますけれども、日本の場合は死刑を 80 から 90% 支持しているという状況があります。
どうぞ。
じゃあ、日本語でしゃべる。法務大臣も国民の高い支持があるということを死刑執行の後の記者会見で言ってます。そういう意味ではそれをよりどこにしてるっていうのは多分あると思います。しかし 86% という今の世論調査っていうのは非常に
トリッキーなクエスチョンでミスリーディングで、人々は聞かれれば最悪のケースを思い出して、あ、やっぱり必要なんじゃないかということの総合体が 86% でありますので、いや、まずはここのフェアなクエスチョンにもう一回戻して、それでも現実的にはまだ日本はマジョリティの人が死刑を維持しているというところはあると思います。しかしその比率っていうのは私はどんどん高まっていると思いますし、本来この問題は世論調査で決定すべきものではないことは明らかになります。
So, as the Minister of Justice in Japan has mentioned in one of his statements that there is a high support rate of toward capital punishment in Japan. He said something like 86%. But I think that this number is very not true and is misleading. And I believe that this 86% is based on the fact thatcapital punishment, death penalty should be executed in a worst case scenario. And so therefore, I think that this question should be addressed from the standpoint of a fair question. And I believe that although the majority states that they are supporting 80s, capital punishment, I believe that we have to not to promoteThe abolition of capital punishment without relying on public opinion.
Okay, this gentleman at the back.
Carsten Germes from Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung in Germany. I have a question to Hakamada-san. First, I have to apologize. This is a very personal question and maybe hurts you a bit, but you told us about the strange behavior your brother showed after released from prison. As I read, conditions in prison were, yes, very hard. This is some sort of torture. In my country, it's even regarded as torture to be in an isolation cell for some time. So could you, if possible, tell us what is the effect, what is the idea and your impression, how far does this way of treatment really try or broke your brother? And is it really, how long will it need, or is it even possible that he might recover and at least enjoy a few lives? Yes.
はかまどさんのお姉様にご質問なんですけれども、これはちょっとパーソナルな個人的な質問になってしまうかもしれませんけれども、冒頭のお話の中で、弟様が、ちょっと回復しつつあると、長い目で見ていきたいというふうにおっしゃいましたけれども、ちょっとおかしな行動をするとこともあるというふうにおっしゃっていましたけれども、この弟様は非常に長いこと拘禁されて、拷問されていたわけなんですけれども、ドイツにおきましてもこういった孤立されたその拘置所で拷問されて、ひどい目に遭うというケースがあるわけなんですけれども、袴田さんはこういった対処置というものに対してどのような思いを抱きでいらっしゃいますでしょうか。または弟さんが全面的に回復するまではどのくらいかかるというふうにお考えでしょうか。
差し支えない範囲でプライバシーに。
今現在は私ということが分かったり分からなかったりしてるんですね。姉であるって言っても姉なんかいないみたいなことまた言うんですよ。だから袴田巌を否定しています。そうかと思うと素直に、私たちの言うことを聞いてなんかムラがあるように思っております。
So to honestly say what the condition of my brotheris that sometimes he does not recognize me, sometimes he does. And he also sometimes does not realize that he has an older sister. And he also sometimes does not realize that he is Hakamada himself. And, but sometimes he listens very sincerely to what we are saying. So there's ups and downs of his condition.
Was there, can I just ask a question? Was there a point where his condition very quickly deteriorated when his sister was visiting him?
この弟さんの訪問された時に、特にこういった時に、状況が悪化していたということはありますでしょうか？悪化している時、どういう時に悪化されしていたかということは分かりますでしょうか？
あの面会している時にやっぱりあの変なことばっかり言っておりました。それが外へ出て多少良くなったのかなと思ったんですが、相変わらず同じ状態でございます。
So, during when he was still in prison, he was saying the same strange things. But as he was released, he seems to be saying the same thing also, but although he has improved somewhat.
あの代用監獄の問題と拘置所における処遇の問題をちょっとあのはっきりさせておきたいと思うんですけども、彼が拷問的な取り調べでひどい目に遭ったのは清水警察署で23日間起訴されるまでの期間、これがひどい拷問的な取り調べを受けたということです。その後拘置所に移されて裁判を受けている最中、それから死刑が確定して死刑囚として東京拘置所で処遇されている、この期間は一応拷問もなければ取り調べもないわけですけれども、適切な処遇が行われたかというとそうではない。例えば精神的なケアが十分だったかといえば不十分だし、栄養管理が十分だったかというと十分ではないために、例えば抗菌反応が出てきたり、それから糖尿病の症状が出てきたりということで、医療的なケアは拘置所でも不十分であったと、こういうことになります。
So I would like to make it clear that as for the torture that Hakamada Iwao experienced, it was during the 23 days when he was interrogated.Before he was convicted at Shimizu police by the prosecutors. And after he was placed in prison until he was brought to trial and he was sentenced to the death penalty, and he was imprisoned in the Tokyo prison cell, there was no torture, there was no interrogation. And however,as for whether he was receiving proper treatment or not, he was not given proper care, or there was some problems in how the nutrition that he was intaking at that moment. And the greatest side effect he experienced is what is called prison side effect and diabetes. And so therefore it is disproves that there was some issues in medical care that was given to him in prison.
Thank you. We have time for another one or two questions. Egawa-san and then Angela. Egawa-san.
フリーランスの江川です。まずあの先ほど警察、検察、裁判所の問題がありましたけれども、もうそれと合わせて、冤罪に関して言うと、あの報道の問題があると思います。あの初期の報道などを見ますと、否認しているとあの、だんまり戦術とかですね、いろんな報道も出ておりました。いまだにあのいろいろ検証なども、メディアの方も行われていないようですけれども、あの袴田さんと、それから秀子さんとですね、それからあの弁護団長の方に、まあ、その報道の問題についてあの今まで、まあ、どうお考えで今どうすべきかということをお伺いしたいと思います。それからもう一つあの西間先生にはあの最新の手続きの問題を先ほどいろいろご指摘なさいました。それについてあの最新の 法制度をですね、変えるための何か具体的なアクションを起こされるのかどうか、特に法制審議会の特別部会で あまり最新のことはさほど議論されてないように思うのですけれども、何かそこでアクションを取られるご予定なのかどうかということをお聞かせください。
My name is Egawa, and I would like to talk about the fact that there has been regarding being falsely accused and the, how these are reported on the press. And there has been reports related to silence being like refraining to accept the actual fact that this person has committed the crime. And it is has been reported sometimes that it was a strategy, strategically using silence to reject the sentence or reject the actual accusation. And so my question is to Hakamoto-san, Hideko-san, and the lawyer, and regarding the press, what do you think we need to do regarding the reportings, the press? And to Ishiba-san, Nishijima-san, to Nishijima-san, there was an issue regarding the retrial issue. I would like to address, there was mention of some reform that needs to take place in terms of the legal structure. Do you intend to take any action to the committee or the organization in order to reform it? regarding the press reportings, Hakamoto Hideko-san does not would like to remain silent. He does not want to say anything about that.
じゃあ私の方から2つの質問について答えます。
So I would like to answer the two questions.
一つはメディアの問題ですけれども、今私どもが最大の関心と協力をお願いしているのはまさにメディアの力を存分に発揮していただいて、不当な検察官の広告をですね。批判していただくと、それから裁判所が検察官の広告を入れてというか、審理をだらだらと長引かせるようなことがないように、速やかに袴田さんの再審公判に移行して、無罪判決が勝ち取れるようにという、そういう側面的な支援に全力を注いでいただきたい、私たちが事件当初のマスメディアに対する批判とか注文は、その後の段階で考えたいと思っております。
So, the first point, the answer to my question for, regarding the press is that the, what I would like to stress at this point is, to ask for your cooperation and the cooperation of the media to utilize the press in order to, criticize the appeal by the prosecutors to bring Hakamoto again to prison and prove him as being guilty. And so therefore, at this point, I would like to, rather than having the trial, the actual trial being redone again, rather than having to spend a necessary amount of time in order to have the actual retrial happen, I would like to have it happen as quickly as possible so that he will be proven innocent. And from this standpoint, I would like to have the press support us strongly. And as for the second, as for the whether the initial criticism that was reported during the time that Hakamoto was accused, I would like to touch upon that after this will be realized.
2つ目の質問でした。再審手続きの改正問題にどのように取り組もうとしているのかという質問だったと思うんですけども、それについてはまず申し上げたいのは、日本弁護士連合会というところで、20年以上前から再審法を全面的に改正すべきだと、正確に言うと刑事訴訟法という法律の中の再審に関する部分、これを僕らは略して再審法と言ってますけども、これを全面的に改めるようにということは、もうすでに古くから言ってるんですけども、なかなか国会で取り上げてもらえないと、ぜひ今回の袴田事件を契機にですね、 従来から日弁連が主張していますように、最新の壁、いわゆる要件を緩やかにするとか、あるいは手続きを公明、透明性を持たせるとか、検察官の即時抗告を許さないとか、証拠にアクセスすることができる、つまり検察官の証拠隠しを少なくとも最新段階では許さないと、こういうことが最小限必要な改正だろうと思いますので、何をおいてもまずは法制審の特別部会に申し入れをするし、大きなキャンペーンを広げていきたいというふうに思っております。
So as for actions that we are taking, that has been taken in order to reform the retrial structure, the Japan Bar Association has ever since 20 years ago been stressing the fact that the retrial law has to be revised. And there is a retrial, the retrial law exists within the criminal law.And we have been, since the long past, been asserting that this has to be reformed. And however, in spite of the fact that this effort has been made by this bar association, the current diet in Japan has not taken this as an issue. And as for the Hakamada issue retrial, I believe that what kind of reform should be made is, for example, to loosen the conditions that is required in doing a retrial to bring it to the court proceedings. We also would like to reform rejecting the immediate appeal by prosecutors, and also to have access to evidence.And also allow retrial to happen immediately. And so, therefore, these are the actions that we have been taking to reform the retrial current structure. And we are campaigning, we have been promoting a campaign in this regard.
Okay, well, we have about a minute left. Angela, if your question's really, really quick, you can get away with it, yep.
Angela Kubo, freelance. This is a question directed to Nishijima-san and Hakamada-san, if she can answer. Concerning the 2010 movie Box, do you think this movie had any effect on the decision to have a retrial? And do you think this movie, how did this movie influence public opinion on this case?
This was a movie about the case, right?
Yes.
Right. 西島さんと袴田さんに、お質問なんですが、2010年に、What was the name of the movie? Box という、Box という映画、この、Box という映画が、放映された、制作されましたけれども、この映画が何だかのこの最新の結論が出るまでの影響があったと思われますでしょうか、何か、効果があったと思われますでしょうか。
個々のキャンペーンといいましょうか、そういったことがどの程度の影響力を持ったかという因果関係はなかなかこれ、立証が難しいんですけども、そういった映画とかそれから記事とかテレビとかそういったことが総体として裁判所を取り囲んで、滅多な結論を出しちゃいけないなという、そういった雰囲気を作っていく上で大きな役割を果たしたのではないかと思います。
So it is difficult to say, like, to what extent campaigns, for example, movies, articles, or TV can place in this kind of a case. But I believe that it is indeed true that from a relative standpoint, we were able to have this conclusion being reached.Hakamada-san has no comment regarding your question.
All right, well, we're out of time. I would just like to ask one yes or no question just to end up the press conference, if that's possible.
この記者会見を終わるにあたり、一つ yes, no で、はい、いいえでお答えしていただきたい点があります。
And this is to Nishijima-san and Wakabayashi-san.
Nishijima-san と若林さんへの質問なんですけども。
Could a case like this happen today?
こういったケースが今日でもまた再び起こる可能性はあると思いますでしょうか。
Yes.
大いにあり得る。
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Well, that's very clear. Thank you. Well, thanks for our three speakers for coming along and giving us a very detailed, interesting presentation in a very compressed time. We're sorry that the time has been so short, but that's the way these things work out. We very much hope that Hakamada-san himself, when he recovers, will come and talk to us at the press conference at the club. That would be wonderful if we could have that. Could you please show your appreciation to the three speakers, particularly to Hakamada-san, who has fought so tirelessly for her brother for all these years. Thank you very much. Thank you.